fossil collecting is really rewarding. You know, it's coming down the beach, lovely scenery for a walk. It's really good trying to find fossils from 200 million years ago along the coastline of South Wales.
About 2 years ago, I found an ichthyosaur skull, and my brother Robert was looking for the rest of the ichthyosaur.
Yeah, I was looking for fossils out at the low tide mark, and I just, on my way back to the car, thought I'd have a look around here in a rockfall, a recent rockfall that had happened. Whilst looking through the rocks, just noticed a few small bits of what I thought were bone. So I picked up some blocks and took them back to the car.
Robert sent me some photographs on the day that he found the bones, and I had a look at them and I thought, ooh, he's found a land animal. So I decided to drive all the way from Preston to South Wales to have a look at what he'd found.
This is an amazing place, this is. It's a beautiful place to be. And I saw, for the first time in my life actually, a theropod dinosaur from the lower Jurassic of Great Britain. And it was amazing. It was the most beautiful little fossil I'd seen in a very, very long time. Dinosaur remains are really rare. This animal is the very first dinosaur from the Jurassic of Wales. There are a few scrappy bits and pieces from the Triassic, slightly older rocks, but this is just inside the Jurassic. It's the oldest dinosaur we know of from the Jurassic, and it's the best specimen from that time period in the whole of the UK, and it's a real first for Wales. Now, one of the great things about this particular dinosaur, it's very complete, and most dinosaurs are known from very scrappy material. We've got about 40% of the skeleton of this one. Some of the bones from the left side, we perhaps don't have the right side, but we can make them up from mirror images. But the other great thing about this is it's from a period of time when we know that the meat-eating dinosaurs were diversifying and there are hardly any specimens. So this animal, or this skeleton, is going to tell us a lot about the evolution of meat-eating dinosaurs. The first thing we can do is we can try to estimate its length. And this animal is going to come out at probably not more than 3 meters long. So it's not the biggest of the meat-eating dinosaurs. On the other hand, the skull bones have all come apart, and so too have some of the little spines that sit on the top of the vertebrae. And that tells us that the animal wasn't fully grown. So it might well have grown up to maybe 5 or 6 meters. But it certainly wasn't one of the biggest dinosaurs. It was ferocious though. Its mouth was lined with tiny little needle-sharp teeth curved backwards with serrated steak knife edges on them. It would have had a quite long back and then a nice gentle curved neck. And its head would perhaps have been, well, no more than 40 centimeters long. Our little dinosaur wasn't alone here in Wales. We have some fragmentary remains of other dinosaurs from slightly older strata. But there were lots and lots of other animals that are around in the Jurassic. There were some small mammals, our very earliest ancestors, but there were other small reptiles as well. And some of these were the ancestors of crocodiles and lizards and other reptiles like that. So it wasn't alone. There were plenty of things to keep it company and also plenty of things for it to eat. I would like to think that this area was going to yield more dinosaurs. This is just a taste of maybe greater things to come. But this find, this is a once in a lifetime find, and I suspect we'll have to wait many, many more years before we find another one.
One of the exciting things was obviously coming down to South Wales from Preston to have a look at the bones. But that evening, finding the skull of the dinosaur was absolutely fantastic. And again, to see that skull being prepared and to see the teeth of a theropod for the first time in 200 million years, you know, you just can't beat that sort of thing.
As soon as my brother and I discovered that it was a dinosaur, our intention was always to donate it to the museum so other people can come and view it, and also scientists can come and view the dinosaur and describe it further.